There is nothing more beautiful than someone who goes out of their way to make life beautiful for others. A very good evening to everyone gathered here today. My topic is the concept of beauty. Being a normal girl with regular beauty concepts, I used to like following beauty and fashion trends even when I was just 9 years old. I paid great attention to the way I looked and what kind of clothes I wore when I went out. Wanting to make a good impression on anyone and everyone I met, I dressed and acted how other people wanted me to. 4 years back, when I was just 10 years old, I stumbled upon one of my mom's friends. She used to donate her hair to the patients of cancer. I read her blog and I was amazed to find out that she was proud of herself for donating her hair. On that day, that's when my life changed. I decided I'd donate my hair to the patients of cancer. In August, I got myself tonsured. On my way to the salon, I waited for my cold feet, and to my surprise, I got none. After the first snip was when I was unfortunate enough to realize that there'd be no turning back. And 15 minutes later, predictably, I was a sobbing, sorry mess, staring at my own hair on the tiles of the salon. I was often told that my hair was my best feature. Along with hiding my rather chunky arms, it also gave me my daily dose of compliments. The much-treasured tale of Rapunzel is a common household story, isn't it? To me, her hair symbolized womanhood and grace. I suppose it's Rapunzel's tale that convinced me that long hair was the mark of beauty and grace in a woman. Without my hair, I felt strangely exposed, and I was more acutely aware of my body than ever before. My movement was awkward, and I didn't use my arms freely. In my society, it's a common norm for a lady to have long hair. How could I go out into public looking like this? Would I look elegant wearing a frock or a gown? How would my chubby face look without my hair framing it and making it look smaller? During the first few weeks, I wondered what madness had inspired me to cut off my beautiful, beautiful hair. But eventually, I got used to not waking up to a head full of hair. I got used to not brushing that particularly annoying lock out of my face every time I bent over. And the best part, I didn't have to take the trouble to tame it and tie it up every time I went out of the house. But I still had the emptiness in me. Regret of losing my best feature. The feature that I thought made me look feminine and beautiful. I still remember, the thing that annoyed me most was when they used to call me Baldy. A month later, I got an email from the organization that had received my hair. They wanted me to know that the girl who owns my hair is happy and that she is the only one in her class with shiny, jet black curly locks. That night, I went to bed with a smile on my face. It's true I'd sacrificed, but I'd helped give somebody a completely normal life. As a child, I had my own conventional idea of beauty. As a teenager, I now realize that beauty is not hair or eyes or body shape. It's kindness and compassion, drive and determination, elegance and poise. I found out that every time I see somebody, I shouldn't judge by the color of their skin, but by how comfortable they are within it and how I feel about myself when they're around me. I shouldn't judge them by the color of their eyes, but by the soft emotions they feel. I began to think, I'd gotten over my own bald-headedness. Why were the other donors and patients of cancer so particular about how they looked that they wanted bandanas and wigs to cover up their baldness? I realized that they asked themselves the same questions I asked myself in the beginning. Would I look nice? How would the society perceive me? I wanted every bald person to feel good and unjudged. I realized I couldn't change everyone's perspective, but I could change the outlook of my peers and classmates. And to a large extent, I'm proud to say I've succeeded. My classmate Vrinda was the first person who took the initiative to cut her hair off. This was yet another thing that showed me that what I did was right. To raise awareness in the society about the fact that differences make you unique, I'd recommend the following. Number one, workshops and donation camps. Workshops and interactive sessions can be held where a student can speak face to face with someone who has broken all the conventional beauty barriers. And most important, workshops where a person will learn to unlearn and then relearn the concept of beauty. Two, visits to cancer patients and survivors. Most cancer patients usually go through a lot of mental trauma because they feel that the society judges them based on their appearance. Therapeutic services can be given to such patients by the donors themselves. And finally, we need somewhere for the patients to relax without the prying eyes of the society. A kind of sanctuary into which they can step into anytime. Maybe a quiet library or a coffee shop, or probably yoga classes that can help them meditate and reflect on the mysteries of nature. A small step forward helped me discover a new person in myself. A person who wasn't afraid to make mistakes. A person who wasn't anxious to act out of the norm. A person who dressed and acted as she liked without worrying about whether she'd be disliked. I learned, unlearned, and then relearned the concept of beauty. Thank you.